Here's what it had to say. I am wholly shocked by some of the allegations purported by ESPN about me personally or about the Phoenix Suns and the Mercury organizations. While I can't begin to know how to respond to some of the vague suggestions made by mostly anonymous voices, I can certainly tell you that some of the claims I find completely repugnant to my nature and to the character of the Suns Mercury workplace, and I can tell you they never, ever happened. Wow. All right, so we bring in Tina Santos here.
Yeah.
What do you think here?
Well, you know, the thing is, I reached out to one of my contacts at ESPN, and he said to maybe sit tight, wait till the report actually comes out. But we have to go into what the rest of the team is saying, because the team did release a statement, and it said, we understand that ESPN is considering publishing a proposed story that makes completely baseless claims against the Suns Legacy Partners LLC organization concerning a variety of topics. Documentary evidence in our possession and eyewitness accounts directly contradict the reporter's accusations, and we are preparing our response to his questions. We urge everyone not to rush to judgment here, especially based on lies, innuendo, and a false narrative to attack our organization and its leadership.
Now, Suns general manager James Jones, he kept it brief, saying, none of what's been described the Robert Sarver I know, respect, and like. It just doesn't.
Now, in regard to the reported accusations, Suns president and CEO Jason Rowley said, in part, this story is completely outrageous and false. It doesn't represent at all the Robert Sarver I've worked alongside of for 15 years. He's not a racist and he's not a sexist. I will also say that reporter in this instance has shown a reckless disregard for the truth. He has harassed employees, former employees, and family members, used truths, half-truths, in rumors to manufacture a story in which he's heavily invested and then perpetuate a completely false narrative within the sports industry to back it up. So Richard, he also went on to say that the reporter's tactics throughout this whole process have been without any basis in journalism ethics or even morality. Right. And we're supposed to hear from Monty Williams shortly. I'm not sure that he's really going to want to take a stance on this. Of course, he's really focused on their game against LA tonight.
Yeah, we'll see what he says. That'll be interesting. Can't wait to hear what Monty has to say, if he can say anything at all. And of course, we'll keep you guys posted on this story as it develops, guys.